thank you for coming in and spending some of your time with me. I think this should be pretty fun.
Great. Well, let's jump in.
What's going on, guys? It's UrAvgConsumer. And as you can see, today we've got a very special video. Your boy got a chance to speak to the man himself, Mark Zuckerberg, on Facebook's latest product, the Ray-Ban Stories. Now, Mark and I had a dope conversation about these. But before we get into that, let's take a look at what these are and what you get when you actually pick them up. So we start off with some pretty clean packaging. The very front shows that this is definitely a Facebook and Ray-Ban collaboration. But once you get past the box, you're greeted with the glasses case. And underneath that, you'll find some paperwork, even a pouch for the glasses, as well as a pretty long USB-C cable to charge the case. Now, when you get your hands on the case, it doesn't feel much heavier than a standard glasses case, even though there's clearly some tech in here to charge the glasses. But when you pull out the Ray-Ban Stories, you'd be surprised at how lightweight and normal they look, even though they've got some cameras and other tech built into them. I've got the Wayfarer version over here, but we also got our hands on the round version for Ari, and they both look really clean. So these right here, you guys, are the Ray-Ban Stories, and they also have another one called the Meteor, and they've got like a ton of different colors and lens options that you guys can pick from, so you can really customize these and get something that works best for you. But I think one of the coolest things about these glasses is that they've got options to add your own prescription. So if you want these to be your all the time glasses that you wear 24/7, you can go ahead and do that as well. And one thing that I really like about these is you can't even really tell that they're smart glasses. Of course, you've got the two lenses up front, so you can clearly see that. But the overall look of it looks pretty normal. It's not super thick, doesn't have anything that really gives away that these are, you know, tech glasses or smart glasses in any way. So I like that. I like that they kept the design nice and clean while still packing a bunch of features. Now let's talk about some of these features. We've got dual 5-megapixel cameras up front. So of course, this is going to be able to capture anything that you've got going on around you. Now it's actually pretty easy to take photos and videos. All you have to do is press the button on the right side. Once and you're recording a video, you can see the white LED light to kind of let people know that you're recording in the moment. And you've got another LED light on the inside, so you can know that you're currently recording something as well. It records for about 30 seconds, and you can always press it again, and then it'll stop. And if you want to take a photo, all you have to do is long press. Yes, Jay, good job. And the whole idea behind like these Ray-Ban Stories is basically being able to live in the moment when you've got things going on, but you still want to record or capture that moment. I personally think that's a great concept. I've been someone who never really minded pulling out his phone, but since becoming a dad and Austin, my son, being the main thing that I capture these days, I've been noticing when I try to capture him doing something cool or interesting, he sees the phone, it distracts him a little bit, it does take away from the moment, but being able to have like a pair of glasses on and being able to hit a button, we can still continue what's going on without him saying like, oh, what's your phone doing out, Dad? And it's actually pretty cool.
You said that?
What? Awesome. What, that phone is out? No, Jay. But he does tend to look at my phone like, what are you doing? Now, what's cool is that you don't actually have to press the button in order to take a photo or a video. You can just say, hey, Facebook, take a video. And then it'll automatically start recording. Hey, Facebook, stop. I never actually tried that, but it works. And of course, there's an app to go along with it. With this app, you're able to import all of the footage that you get on your Ray-Ban Stories right into your phone. And you can actually go inside of here, kind of preview everything that you've got going on. You can even go in here and make edits to the content, share them out directly to things like Facebook, Instagram, and any other way that you'd like to share it. And that's actually not even the end of it, you guys. These also have a pair of speakers built into them, so you can go ahead and listen to music while you've got these on, or you can even take calls. And now I know the first thing you're wondering, how does that work? Because there's nothing going into your ears. They're speakers, so they play aloud, but it's actually not too bad. If I crank the volume all the way up, people around you aren't going to be like, oh man, turn that down. The listening experience is still actually pretty private. And because these have speakers built into them as well as microphones, you know that means you can also take calls. And you'd be concerned that like somebody can hear your conversation. They actually can't. Jay and I actually tried this out in a few different situations outside, listening to music, taking phone calls. I was talking to my dad for a good bit. Jay couldn't understand anything that he was saying. So I feel pretty confident. My dad speaks really loudly. And yeah, you know it, Jay. We even tried it out in the car, which actually turned out to be a pretty cool situation. In case you don't want your phone call to be on speaker in your car, but you still need to take it, but you can't put your phone to your face. So you can actually have it on here and feel pretty confident that no one's able to hear your conversation. Now, of course, with something like this that works like a Bluetooth headphone, you're going to get controls to control your audio. So there's actually no extra buttons, but there is a touch panel on the right side. So if you want to play and pause your music, you can just tap once, and you can, of course, double tap to skip a track, triple tap to go back a track, and even has swipe controls moving forward to turn your volume up, swiping back to turn the volume down. Now, you might be wondering about battery life, and these are rated for about 6 hours of moderate use. And just like a pair of truly wireless earbuds, you can go ahead and throw them in the charging case to protect them as well as charge them. And with this, you get an additional 3 full charges. So big shout out to Ray-Ban and Facebook for kind of putting this whole thing together. I think it's pretty dope. These are going to retail for about, guess.
$299.
Carl's right.
Hey.
Oh. These are going to go for $299, which isn't a bad price at all. I think standard Ray-Bans start at, I think $199 or something in that range. And these, for all the tech that you're adding to it, it's just like $100 more while still looking like a pair of Ray-Bans. So they did a really good job with these, but you know who can talk about these a lot better than I can? Mark Zuckerberg. So Mark, thank you for coming on and spending a little bit of your time with me. Definitely means a lot to hear from the man himself what Ray-Ban Stories is going to be and how it's going to be able to help people. Right now, I think a lot of people will have heard about the Ray-Ban Stories. They'll understand that these are a pair of smart glasses. But I'm curious, what are they to you? And what made you want to bring them to life?
We're on this journey to try to create the augmented reality glasses that I think we all envision for the future, where you can have these holograms in front of you and get turn-by-turn directions, play chess or ping pong or whatever game you want with people, even if they're thousands of miles away. And the technology for that is still being developed, so that's a few years off. But while we're working on that, we wanted to basically start building the smartest glasses that we could. Here's the ones that I use. I wear this kind of brownish color. I think of this, it's not just a good product that I've enjoyed using on a day-to-day basis. I mean, I take it skiing and surfing and all these kind of crazy conditions, and it's held up pretty well, and I've gotten some pretty good footage. But it's also, I think, the first real step on this journey to having augmented reality, to having kind of smart glasses on the path to augmented reality glasses that are like in a good form factor that you'd want to wear around. And I think that's going to be an important journey over the next 5 years. It's something I'm really excited about.
That's awesome. So I see a lot of like use cases for something like this. Because I've been a dad for like a year now, and I'm always pulling out my phone 24/7, trying to capture as many moments as possible. There are some situations though where it just doesn't feel right to pull it out. Like if I take my son to his little gym class and having him climbing on top of things, I want to be present, aware, ready to grab him if I need to, but I also want to capture that, send it to my wife so she can see what he did. I feel like this kind of opens the door to those kind of possibilities. So for me, I'm always thinking of technology in the end users or the customers. What value do you envision like the end customer getting from purchasing a pair of these?
Yes, I think you hit it exactly. Basically, you're able to easily capture experiences from your perspective without taking yourself out of the moment, right? You don't need to have your phone out. You don't even need to have your phone with you to capture the experience, which is great not just for following your kids around and capturing things while staying in the moment with them, But, you know, I've been able to capture stuff that I wouldn't have even been able to otherwise. So, you know, ever since watching the Olympics with my daughters, I used to fence competitively, and I was like, all right, I want to teach my kids how to fence. So, you know, I've been, you know, putting on my Ray-Ban glasses and basically, you know, I have a foil in one of my hands. So, you know, I'm not gonna like be able to film while I'm sword fighting with my daughters, but I have these kind of crazy videos of you know, Max, you know, lunging at me and just like, and hitting our blades together, and it's wild, right? And you just wouldn't have been able to capture that otherwise, no matter what, even if I was willing to take my camera out, it's just not a thing that I could have done. So, I think, you know, the bigger picture here though, is I think over the next, I don't know, decade or so, we're gonna move towards a world where phones are just a lot less central to our lives. And I view this as the beginning of that journey, but it really unlocks a bunch of use cases to help people capture moments when they're hanging out with family or going on a hike or cooking, where it just wouldn't be reasonable to take out your phone today.
Now, I do know that with, of course, glasses like these, cameras involved, privacy is going to be something that's going to be on the forefront of a lot of people's minds. How much thought to privacy goes into the making of a product like this?
It's a ton of thought. I mean, this is clearly going to be an area that people think a lot about, both for your own privacy as the wearer and the privacy of the people around you. So, you know, it's really important that, you know, it's never recording unless you tell it to, right? If you tell it to, you know, you do the long press to take a photo or tap it to take a video, and the video also ends after a short period of time. So you're never gonna get in a state where it's just kind of recording for long periods of time. For the privacy of the people around you, we built in an LED light. So anytime the camera is active, the light is on, so that way the people around you know, hey, there's a camera on that that's activated. There's something on these glasses that's activated. And I think it's just worth noting that, you know, having an LED light next to the camera is going further than any smartphone does today, right? So that's, you know, that's not the norm on phones. We have our phone and we're constantly taking taking photos and videos. So this goes further than any kind of those products that are out on the market in terms of making it so that it's clear to the people around you.
I always find it interesting when a company that maybe first started with software goes into the hardware space and just kind of bring something new to the table.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you have a company that's focused on helping people kind of share their moments and experiences, then it makes a lot more sense to be building a product like this. You know, we started off by building Facebook, you know, built that to be a popular product that a lot of people used. And then, you know, the next chapter of the company was building a number of other apps, right? So whether that's Instagram or WhatsApp or Messenger to be pretty big and popular experiences too. But my hope is that in the next few years, we become more known as a metaverse company working on these types of experiences than just a social media company.
So Mark, definitely, I appreciate you taking the time speaking with me. I'm so glad that you were able to give me some super cool insight on what the Ray-Ban stories are and how, you know, just the average person can really take advantage of them and what they can expect from, you know, using something like this.
Awesome, well, happy to do it. I'm really excited to get the product into more people's hands.
All right, thanks a lot, Mark.
All right, I'll catch you soon. Thanks for having me on.
Good talking to you.
You too.
But that about wraps it up for this video, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully you got a nice idea of what the Ray-Ban stories bring to the table and what Facebook has in mind for the future. Mark was super dope to give me some of his time and kind of give us some more insight into why these exist. So huge shout out to him and his team. If you guys are interested, I'll of course have links down below in the description, but I'll catch you guys in the next one. Till then, it's your average consumer. Peace. So guys, how cool do I look?
You look high.
This guy.